And I'm Judy Woodruff.
Our team kept the live blog updated by the second with real-time analysis and reaction from both sides. The hat cam we first introduced during the political conventions set out once more, checking in on a debate watch party. And we closed out the morning hours with a live Google Plus hangout. Political editor Christina Bellantoni chatted with two undecided voters about the debate's impact on their choice in November.
The way I feel after watching this debate, I don't know how much good it's going to do for me to watch it.
Yeah.
To be honest, the idea of not voting seems terrible, but when I'm picking between the lesser of two evils, like I said, I don't know how much good I'm doing that way either.
I am very, like, against the political apathy that I see in a lot of, kind of my peers. And, you know, this is a big chance to be able to vote and feel like your vote decides something. And, you know, that people, that someone out there is calling you wondering how you're voting.
We'll keep up the coverage for the next debates, including the meeting of the vice presidential contenders on Thursday.
You can watch all of last night's Google Hangout and the debate in its entirety online. See how two analysts, one Democrat and one Republican, graded President Obama and Governor Romney's performances. Plus, on ArtBeat, Jeff talks to writer Kevin Powers. His new novel, The Yellow Birds, centers on a 21-year-old Army private fighting in Iraq. All that and more is on our website, newshour.pbs.org.